Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another Daily Market Report brought to you by Mike Bjork. Today is Thursday. It's September 14th. We got a couple economic news releases scheduled for today. As we mentioned earlier this week, it's been kind of a light week this week. We just got kind of today and tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll get retail sales. Today we got, you know, the inflation CPI number coming out. Otherwise, it's pretty light week this week. So a lot of stuff, you know, for the most part, will be taken by geopolitical. But today will be the exception, which we'll kind of get into in a second. Because it's Thursday, we always get the weekly jobless claims, so we'll start off with that. So last week, we had 297,000 people apply for unemployment. Forecast was supposed to be in that same range at 300,000, and actually dipped a little bit to 284,000. Now, these next few weeks or month or so, we're going to probably see a bit of a spike in jobless claims. Why? Because, of course, we had Hurricane Harvey and now Irma coming through, and a lot of those people are going to be without jobs, at least hopefully just on a temporary basis. But in the meantime, they're going to apply, probably, most likely apply for unemployment to be able to at least get some type of wages coming in. You know, of course, we all have bills to pay, so they, you know, they're no different. So they need to pay their bills in the meantime while they are unable to work in the process. So, so expect a spike here in this area for the next month or two as a result. And then we get into the holidays, we'll probably see that dip a bit, and we'll probably see a big spike in job growth because we'll have a lot of temporary employment due to the holidays. You know, people, a lot of retailers and people like that hiring for the holiday sales coming up. Last but not least, we got the CPI, the two reports here. So this is the headline number, Consumer Price Index. This is inflation numbers for the consumers. So this is an important gauge, but the main one that the Fed looks at is called the PCE, or the personal consumption expenditure, but they still do view this as well. So back in July, we had a 0.1% increase in the Consumer Price Index. Forecast was 0.3%, and it went up 0.4%. Now, a lot of this was went up primarily due to, you know, with the hurricanes coming in, the price of oil rising as a result of that. This is what why we had a pretty big spike in consumer price index. Now, what we do is we take out food and energy, which creates that volatility, and we get the core CPI. And this is really what the Fed will be gauging as to a true inflationary number here. So July, we had a 0.1%. Forecast was supposed to be 0.2%, and it came in expectations at 0.2%. So here's how it kind of works year over year. The headline number went from 1.7% to 1.9%, and the core remained the same at 1.7 to 1.7. So still away from the 2% target, but that 2% target, again, is really geared towards the PCE number, which is down to, I believe, 1.4, which is very, very low. We were up at 1.8, and it dropped down to 1.4 over the last, you know, 4 or 5 months here on that. This is a lot of big reason why a lot of people don't think the Fed will be raising rates, because inflation is just too low. The reason why that they raise rates to begin with is to stave off any inflationary problems. And again, this is not an issue at this time right now. And so the big thing for next week when the FOMC does meet, they're going to be looking for any clues as to when and how they're going to start unwinding their balance sheet that they accumulated when they started doing the quantitative easing, so which they accumulated about $4.5 trillion worth of assets, and how they're going to start unwinding, or which basically means they're going to start selling that off. So let's take a look here at the headline news. The stock market's a bit mixed. They all kind of started off in a slightly negative pattern, but the Dow kind of went up a little bit. Now, we've been kind of going at highs the last couple of days. They've been kind of going, you know, after they were relieved by Irma not being as devastating as they initially thought, even though there was devastation, but just they expected a lot more. And then, you know, the threats of North Korea, with the they thought they were going to have a missile launch, which would create more tensions, and that didn't happen. So the stock market started taking off. We started reaching new highs on that. Today, they're kind of taking a little bit more of a break. So it's not so much due to, you know, that there's really no news or anything, but it's just taking a little bit of a break. We did get a new threat by North Korea yesterday, but it's not really factoring in the market. They're basically saying they're going to sink Japan with a nuclear bomb, and they're going to turn America to ashes. So that's their newest threat, because that was kind of their retaliation for the UN putting in with more restrictions about their exports and then any oil imports going into the country, which, of course, displeased them. Today, the B of E, which is the Bank of England, came in. They had their meetings and basically left everything unchanged in terms of rates as well as quantitative easing. They did make note that they think the pricing out there in the markets are pricing in that there's no rate hikes coming in. And they said they kind of give a little more forewarning that the rates could be rising faster than you and what's being priced in the market. So they kind of give them a heads up here. And of course, the pound went up, became a little bit stronger as a result of those comments. So let's take a look here at the bond markets. See what's going on over here. We did start off the day off lower, so here we went downward. We have this downward trend beginning here, and so far we're between the 25-day moving average, and we're behind, and we got support here at the 50-day moving average. So as you can see, we were down even a lot further, almost touching off that 50-day moving average. But since we've kind of pulled up a little bit, right now we're up about 3 basis points from where we left off yesterday. It dipped a bit, especially after the CPI report, which came in with more inflation, but since have kind of subsided a little bit here. That's why you see a little bit more of an improvement. Typically, when you see inflation, bond market will ne act negatively, but they may view it as a little temporary, but also getting a little bit of reprieve because the stocks are taking a slight break after being at highest. So you're kind of getting more of that break, more of a less a break, I think, because they've been going that new highs. Now they're just kind of taking a little bit of a break, and that's kind of helping out bonds today. So let's take a look at the 10-year treasury here. Same thing. We were up higher, the yields. We were up over 220, as you can see here. Now so far we're about 219, 2.19. So again, on this one we're still kind of between the 25 and the 50-day moving average. One thing that we got to see is that we got a lot of room here where 10-day moving average could, I mean between here and the 25. Yeah, 50-day moving average. We got a little room there where yields could rise more, which would hurt interest rates here as well. So same thing as what we saw, kind of influx or inflection of what the bond market was showing. So there's room there. So it's possible that we could see some further deterioration in the near term. Again, we're starting to get this pattern here where we got an upwards trend. How long it lasts, it's hard to say. But with the tax reform being discussed, if they get some type of agreement, we get some type of a win, so to speak, out of Congress, you could definitely see stock market taking off, and that would be at the cost of interest rates going up. So longer term, I would say rates most likely will be going up in the longer term. Short term, we might have a few bumps here and there where we might get improvements and a little bit worsening again. So, all right, folks, so that pretty much concludes it. It's kind of a little long today. I apologize. But if you guys want more updates throughout the day, just come over to Twitter. You can find me on Twitter at Mike Bjork. So basically, as we conclude, rates are about the same as where we left off. Again, it's up about 3 basis points. Not really enough to make a difference in either direction. So basically, the rates are the same as what we left off yesterday. You guys have a wonderful day. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.